Okay, so for level two, this time they're doing the same thing as level one. Their number is 1, 2, 3. However, in one of your equations, you can easily see the slope, but in your other equation, you can't. So we need to find the slope in the other equation. And how we do that is we put it in slope-intercept form. So that means that we isolate y. So starting off number one, I'm going to subtract 2x from both sides. So I have a 3y is equal to a negative 2x plus 6. Then I divide by 3 on both sides. When we divide by 3 on both sides, we get y is equal to a negative 2/3 x, and don't forget you have to divide that 6 by that 3, so plus 2. So my slope of this equation is negative 2/3. My slope of my second equation is 3/2. Since those are opposite reciprocals, then this means that the lines are perpendicular. And the reason being is because they were opposite reciprocal slopes. All right, jumping into number two, same thing. I'm going to isolate y by subtracting 2x from both sides. I wind up with a negative y is equal to a negative 2x plus 2. Then I need to divide by negative 1 on both sides to get a y is equal to a 2x, and I need to do a 2 divided by a negative 1, so that's a minus 2. So my slope of this line is 2. My slope of my second line is negative 2. So these are neither parallel or perpendicular because the slopes are just opposites. They're not opposite reciprocals, and they're not the same slope. All right, and then number three, same thing. I'm going to first subtract 2x from both sides. And so I have a negative 2y is equal to a negative 2x plus 6, dividing by negative 2 on both sides. I get y is equal to a positive x minus a 3, which my slope of this line is the coefficient of x, which is just 1. So my coefficient of x here is 1, so that's my slope there. And my slope here is 1/2. So these lines are neither because the slopes are not the same. Or opposite reciprocals. Great. So number four says, if a line is perpendicular to this, will it be perpendicular to this other equation as well? We need to explain. So let's find the slope of this other equation by subtracting x. I'm left with a negative 2y is equal to a negative x plus 14. And then dividing by negative 2. Y is equal to a positive 1/2 x minus a 7. So actually, these two are not perpendicular to begin with. I think I changed yours to parallel. And that's how we did this problem. So this line that we are given is parallel to x because they have the same slope. So if I have a line that's parallel to this line, then it's also going to be parallel to this line. So let's explain. Be our explanation there. Okay, so number five, it says, what is the slope of the line? So let's go ahead and let's find it by first subtracting 2x from both sides. So I have a negative y is equal to a negative 2x plus 8. And then I would need to divide by negative 1 on both sides to get y is equal to a 2x minus 8. So my slope of this line is 2. So what is the slope of any line that would be parallel to the line? It needs to also be the same slope, so it would be 2. Then it says write an equation of the line in slope-intercept form through the point and parallel to the line. So you can go ahead and write this in slope-intercept form if you wish. Point-slope form if you wish, and then convert it into slope-intercept form. That's a way that you can do this. I'm going to show you the other method again, which this point is xy, and so I have the equation y is equal to mx plus b. If I put 6 in for y, my slope of 2 in for m, and negative 3 in for x, I can find b by solving for b. So here I would have 6 is equal to a negative 6 plus a b. I would then add 6 to both sides to get that b is 12. So then I write my equation as y is equal to my slope was 2 and my b is 12. So I wanted to show you that method again, just in case you liked that one better. All right, number 6 says to find an equation of a line through this that's parallel to these lines here. So x is equal to 5 is a vertical line on the graph. So if we're dealing with a vertical line on the graph and we want a line parallel to that, it is also going to be a vertical line. So it's going to be x is equal to a number. And that number is the x value of the point that's given to you. And for the next one, this is a horizontal line on the graph. And if we have a line that's parallel to a horizontal line, then that means that it's also going to be a horizontal line. So your equation would be y is equal to the y value of the point that's given to you. And that's it for those two. All right, and then number 7, it says to write the equation of the line in slope-intercept form that passes through this point B, but it's parallel to AC. So if we want it to be parallel to AC, we need to find the slope of AC. So I'm going to label my points x1, y1, and x2, y2 for A and C, and I'm going to find the slope. All right, so this is the slope of AC. Is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1 minus a negative 6 is really a plus 6. So I have a negative 6 over a negative 4, which reduces to a positive 3/2. That's my slope. And if I want a line that's parallel to that, this is still going to be my slope of that line. And then it's going to go through the point for negative 3. So I'm going to label that point xy or x1, y1. And let's go ahead. I'll show you the other method now. So I showed you this method earlier. I'm going to show you the other method. You can decide what you like better. But here, we're going to write our equation in point slope form. So y minus the y1 value of point B. So y minus a negative 3 is really a y plus a 3. Is equal to your slope times x minus your x1 value of point B. And then now we distribute and solve for y. So distributing it, the 3 halves in, I have a y plus a 3 is equal to a 3 halves x. And then this is going to be a minus 12 halves, which reduces just to a 6. So then subtracting 3 from both sides, I wind up with my equation being y is equal to a 3 halves x minus 9. All right, so that brings us to the end of level 2.